Oh, I saw Senator Balloon.
He will help us, I suppose. Balloon is a whole-hearted fellow. I can't help loving that man, for all his drollery and waggishness. He puts on an air of levity sometimes, but there ain't a man in the Senate knows the Scripture as he does. He did not make any objections?
Not exactly. He said... Shall I tell you what he said? Asked Laura, glancing furtively at him.
Certainly.
He said he had no doubt it was a good thing, if Senator Dilworthy was in it. It would pay to look into it.
The Senator laughed, but rather feebly, and said, Balloon is always full of his jokes.
I explained it to him. He said it was all right. He only wanted a word with you, continued Laura. He is a handsome old gentleman, and he is gallant for an old man.
My daughter, said the Senator, with a grave look, I trust there was nothing free in his manner.
Free? Repeated Laura, with indignation in her face.
With me? There, there, child, I meant nothing. Balloon talks a little freely sometimes with men, but he is right at heart. His term expires next year, and I fear we shall lose him.
He seemed to be packing the day I was there. His rooms were full of dry goods boxes, into which his servant was crowding all manner of old clothes and stuff. I suppose he will paint Pub Docks on them and Frank them home. That's good economy, isn't it?
Yes, yes. But, child, all congressmen do that. It may not be strictly honest. Indeed, it is not, unless he had some public documents mixed in with the clothes.
Isn't it a funny world? Goodbye, Uncle. I'm going to see that chairman.
And humming a cheery opera air, she departed to her room to dress for going out. Before she did that, however, she took out her notebook and was soon deep in its contents, marking, dashing, erasing, figuring, and talking to herself.